Yeah. First of all, it's very important to also understand that I'm not saying about not working on your business. Sometimes you have to put in the work, you have to put in the hours, you have to put in the effort. Like, this is your business, this is quote unquote your baby. So, like, it means the world to you. And you have to have days, weeks, months where you basically strategize and do the things you're supposed to be doing. What I'm saying is that you have to look like the broader picture. What are the things, what are the actions, what are the tasks that you need to do in order to help your business? Because, first of all, there are these people that, you know, I like to say productive procrastinators, who they are like religious to the mentality of hustling 24/7, 365. And they just work to make, you know, an Instagram story and show to everyone that, oh, look, you know, I'm working, I'm an entrepreneur. That's one of the things. Now, in order to do that, first of all, you have to understand what are the tasks that you need to do, that you enjoy doing, and that will be profitable to your business. And in order to do that, I use a concept called VIP. So V means, is the task I'm about to do valuable for my business? Is it going to make me money? Yes or not? Number two, I, it needs to be important. Is it something that maybe shouldn't even be on your task list or not? And as concerning P, it should be something that you are passionate about doing. If any task does not, you know, follow along the VIP principle, I either delegate it or completely eliminate it. Now, in order to outsource it or delegate it, the whole idea is using virtual assistants from the Philippines, which is like, those people are amazing. They have great work ethic. Their English is amazing as well, and they can do so many things really good, and they won't cost any the entrepreneur a lot of money. Well, I mean, it really depends on the person, but generally tasks like changing the colors of the banner of your Facebook page or your Facebook group shouldn't be something that you, like, if you're an entrepreneur and you want to scale your business, it's not your task to make sure that it's done so that, you know, you grow your business. Like, it is completely insignificant, the result you're gonna have from it. Or maybe you going on Facebook and posting your post on your own, or YouTube, or, you know, and I know it's the same thing that you say as well many times, that you should focus on the tasks that will make you money instead of just focus on creating content again and again without having a strategic concept, an idea behind that. So yeah, basically outsource or eliminate every single task that will not follow the VIP principle. This is like the basis. People can think about it like, what are the tasks that no one else can do than me? For example, this podcast, my team cannot do the podcast. I can be here. I cannot, my videos should be shot by me. I should be giving the content, but I shouldn't be the one who is editing the videos and posting the videos. Another thing would be marketing, the whole vision building. Where do you want to go your business? How do you want to grow your business? What kind of products do you want to develop? These are the very fundamentals that we neglect to see simply because we want to hustle and work and grind, and we forget to put in the work to the things that matter the most. There are different ways to go about it. First thing first, the entrepreneur needs to know what are the actual tasks that he will outsource, how long those tasks will take, and maybe how he will structure the whole idea. So first of all, what I always say to people is track and rank your tasks based on, okay, what are the tasks that I do every single day, which of them should be outsourced, and for each one of those tasks, basically what an entrepreneur needs to do is to create video training for the virtual assistants. And there are different ways to do that. You can do it over Zoom, or you can use a platform called useloom.com, where you basically screen share your screen while you're doing the task for yourself and for your business. And while you're doing that, you're basically also explaining to the virtual assistant, so I'm doing this because I want that, then you click here, then you drag this there, then you write this as a description, and then you post, and that's it. Use Loom is what I personally use. It's it's a pretty straightforward app. There is also a Google Chrome extension, and it's like, and then you just simply serve the link. You don't even need to upload the video on YouTube or somewhere else. You create the video, you click record, you record it, you stop the video, and then you send the link to the virtual assistants, and you're done. As concerned the people that are on the Empowered Entrepreneur Secrets training, basically what we do is we're taking e-commerce entrepreneurs and freelancers, which are the people that are most in need of a team, and we take them through a self-development journey to begin with. So think of it like a leadership self-development journey. First, we make sure that the entrepreneurs become leaders of themselves by becoming more productive, knowing what is their why, what is their greatest vision. Then we follow along with motivation, how they can find this fire, this spark from within themselves, so that they can propel and accelerate themselves in order to go to where they deserve to be. And then we also create an action plan for them in order to go from where they are to where they want to end up. That's the first thing. Then we continue by making them leader on their social circle, which involves family, friends, girlfriends, boyfriends, partners. Because if you're an entrepreneur, you're putting the work, but your surrounding are toxic people that keep you down, throw you down every time you try to go towards what you deserve to have in your life, then you will be stopped. Like, you will feel the pain within yourself. And we all been through those moments. And they say, you know, like, one of my favorite quotes is that your network is your net worth. And it's a big one. And then after that, we make sure to train those entrepreneurs in the leadership skills they will need in order to manage their teams, hire the virtual assistants, and then scale their business using those virtual assistants. And as concerning your second question, we basically want people that are not afraid to take the action, that love the process, that are ethical, that they don't want to manipulate people. We want basically to create a new breed of entrepreneurs who are changing the world while also living their lives. If someone is happy hustling all day long, 100%, like, I understand that some people like to be workaholics. But if someone understands that there is more in life than just sitting strapped on your computer wearing golden handcuffs, then, you know, these are the people we want to have. Not only for the members of your team, but also for yourself, because when you don't know what's your vision, what's your why, as we say, then you don't know where to go. Like, you're moving blindlessly towards somewhere, whereas you have to be a specific step-by-step process from where you are to where you want to go. Of course, your why, your vision, your purpose will change over the time, because you as an entrepreneur, you are changing over time. You have new stimuli, you have new ideas, new people you meet, and then maybe your purpose might shift a little bit, but still, it's important for you to know where you want to end up, so that then you translate and communicate that to your team, and then you have to motivate them in order to put in the work and represent your brand as well. And that's another one. You don't want anyone to join your team. You want people that want to work with you and not for you, because they believe in the same vision as you, that failure is your best friend no matter what. And in order to make money, you have to lose money, you have to spend money, and you have to fall down again and again and again, feel the pain and keep going. People believe that failure is something that we should stay away from and we should protect ourselves, but I believe quite the opposite. I think that without failure, I wouldn't be who I am, because you learn so many beautiful things from failure, as long as you stop, think, and analyze, okay, what was my mistake, why I did that mistake, and how can I change it, how can I learn from it? As long as you have this growth mindset within yourself, then anything that comes to you is a win. And you will fail. This is non-negotiable. I don't know any entrepreneur who didn't fail. And it's the biggest blessing you can have in your life. There are different things. Number one, the basic thing is to start using the habits that will help you to go out from all those negative mindset problems. For example, morning routines and affirmations. Affirmations work like charm. And for the entrepreneurs that are listening right now, my favorite affirmation, and feel free to use it, please use it actually, is I'm so happy and grateful now that money comes to me in increasing quantities through multiple sources on a continuous basis. When you wake up, you look yourself at the mirror and you embody those words, those phrases with emotions and with movement, then it becomes a part of your subconscious as well. And then you project that to the world when you're going out and you're displaying your message, but also it comes from within yourself, like you create this spark that then will become a flame and you will be able to literally do everything you want. That's the first thing. Another thing is also meditation. Because instead of just, you know, being focused on, oh, I did a mistake, oh, I failed, oh, I got rejected, oh, I missed this opportunity, what meditation helps you to do is basically to clear your mind and focus on the things that do matter and realize that, okay, this is what happened now, okay, I don't live in the past, I don't live in the future, I live in the now, in the right here, in the right now. Can I do anything to change it? Yes or no? I can, great, I'll do something. If I can't though, I should just let it go. Yes, sir. Apart from morning routines and habits, another very useful concept for people to study is stoicism. Concepts like, you know, the dichotomy of control, which is like, can focus on the things that you can control and not on the things that you cannot control. Or also things like, and this is how you actually start your podcast, you know, the memento mori concept, the mortality, that we are going to die. And since we're going to die, why are you still giving a damn about your failures? Change those things and become the version of yourself that you were meant to become, because you never know when, you know, you might have to leave this place. Do everything you can, live your life to the fullest, enjoy life, put in the work, and stop thinking what happened yesterday. Focus on today, make today epic, and the future will also come in a similar way. Yeah, then you just go into a downward spiral and you just multiply the negative effect 10 times, 100 times, million times. You just keep digging deeper, deeper and deeper, trying to find ways to justify the reason why you failed. Whereas when you just simply learn from it and let it go, you won. Right now we have an 8-week intensive accountability course where we take those people into the self-development journey. That's one of the things. And apart from that, we're also having a free masterclass where we give the basics to entrepreneurs to watch it, learn from it, and then they can also schedule a call with me and my team, and we can also give them a specific blueprint of how to create their teams and how to basically create their plan for the next 6 months. Apart from that, now on the plans, we want to slowly create like the Empowered Entrepreneur Live. This is something that I really love. I love public speaking and I really want to make this to happen. It's a more of a long-term plan, to be fair, but this is where I want to eventually take Empowered Entrepreneur, because this will give the opportunity to more people to also network, meet other like-minded individuals. And since I found most of my friends, mentors, and people that helped me through live events and through this networking thing and events, I really want to give the opportunity to people to do something similar like that. So the best way to contact me directly is on Instagram, which is Yannis_Pantelis. I'm very active there. I respond to every single DM. And I upload content every single day, and you will also see the background of the business and everything on my stories. That's one of the things. I will also have a podcast. It's called Empowered Entrepreneur Podcast. You can watch it on Spotify, or you can listen to Spotify, or just watch it on Facebook and YouTube. And other than that, if you go to our website, which is called EmpoweredEntrepreneurSecrets.com, you can find all the trainings there and enjoy it, and definitely schedule a call with us, and we'll be very happy to discuss in more depth everything you might need.